Hi, I'm Nicholas Sparks. I'm an author, and one of my favorite things is the play Romeo and Juliet by, guess who? William Shakespeare. You know, I first read this play when I was a high school sophomore, and at the time I did not understand anything, right? It's this Elizabethan old English. I had to run out and get the cliff notes and try and make sense of it. And I was wondering, gosh, is this the way people really talked back then? I really didn't understand why the teacher had us go through this. But over time, as I've reread the play and I've really taken that story down to its elements, I realize, ideally, that it's kind of part and parcel with it, with what I'm attempting to do in my own work, right? It's this tremendous love story between these two young people, and the passion they feel for each other is just as intense as anything you can imagine, right? Same thing I tried to do with Noah and Allie, for instance. And yet, their two families, you know, they just don't get along, and these two are forced to be apart, and it's a story of this conflict of how they try to be together, and it's a story of how deeply they actually love each other. And then, of course, you add in this whole tragic element at the end, probably, in my opinion, the most tragic story ever written. And to me, the story works on so many different levels. It's a story that has been modified and rewritten, you know, is something Ernest Hemingway did in A Farewell to Arms, right? He takes this love story between these two people, and then you've got this tragic element. No one ever did it better than William Shakespeare. No one probably ever will. And all I can do is to try to do my best to live up to this amazing standard that the English language genius created.